Mark Dubridge into the world's top 10 once again. Now is Mark Walsh, world number 8 after recovering from dartitis. Your commentary team, John Gwynn and Dave Lanning.
You could hardly get a black-headed Blackpool gull into the Winter Gardens, where they've just seen sporting soap opera. And this one, you know, John, could be tungsten theatre, because both these players, Kevin Painter, you can see his CV there, and Mark Walsh, are both solid hitters.
Yeah, both gullible, I suppose, in a sense. Both have almost lost here during the course of these last few days. Painter, we've heard, 8-2 down, 9-5 down. Thought he was going to lose it then. And Walsh, you know, 5-0 up against Dunbridge. And in the end, having been 8-7 down, he just about managed to squeeze through, as you can see, 12-10. Now, the same man was 5-0 up against Tony Ayres at the UK Open and actually went on to lose the game. So, no matter
first
how far Walsh is
there,
should he get it? Don't assume it's all over, because the man in black behind him is never beaten. So away we go. The winner has either Phil Taylor or Steve Beaton to play in the quarters, but that's the last thing on their minds right now. It's getting there for the first time in each case, or either case, that matters at the moment.
Yes, they have both survived squeakers, as our friends in America say. There is Kevin Painter's stepfather, Rob, there, who really turned a few mental somersaults while Kevin was having that battle with Colin Lloyd. Remember, 8-2 down, somehow he managed to recover from that. So he may well feel, John, that having got over what amounts to Beecher's Brook, that this may be his year. Between the pair of them, they've been dismissed at this stage on 9 occasions. And last year, Painter, just coming into the mark now, was beaten by Phil Taylor. And that was the third time he's met Taylor in Blackpool. He must be...
Wow.
And of course, if he wins here tonight, chat star, he might meet Taylor again. And we have some extroverted characters, shy, unassuming people come to darts in Blackpool.
Well, there was a bit of piracy on Painter's part, wasn't he, when he beat Colin Lloyd? And he will be looking forward to this contest. I met him only a few moments ago, in fact, and said he was very, very relaxed, looking forward to it. And I'm sure that Mark Walsh would have said exactly the same had I seen him. Looks it anyway. 45 scored, 17 left. Now, double 8 for the first leg.
46. And
what an opportunity for Painter to steal a march here. Big checkout, 128 would be just what the doctor ordered. Treble 20 now, a must for the ball not to be.
63.
So Mark Walsh, who already has 60. Had one dart at finish, has 3 darts now, and needs one up to the man from Abbots Langley.
Second leg, it's Kevin to throw first.
So first leg going with throw. Yeah, Abbots Langley, just a few miles from Watford in Hertfordshire. And this man from Daventry, originally 30. Essex, as we made great fuss of, really, the fact that he was a fellow Essex man, and Colin Lloyd, his first round victim.
140
as an Essex lad as well, but lives in Daventry, Northamptonshire, not a million miles from Silverstone. Touster.
140.
Walsh is, what, 10 places above Kevin Painter in the rankings. And he started this tournament at 80-1, which is a bit shorter than Kevin Painter, 125-1. So you would just about fancy that the odds favour Walsh, but Painter, we know, is a pretty determined infighter. We saw fair witness to that against Colin Lloyd. Here's Walsh looking for 180.
Ross Fraser out for Chipman as well, and his county colleague making him shout. The first 180 of the match, and I guess there'll be a few more.
Mark, you require 81.
For old gravel voice to give us. Oh, lovely dart. Double 12 here for a breaker through.
Game
clean and a whistle.
Now we heard right at the top of this match that Kevin Bates said he can't afford to be so sluggish away from the tapes. He was a very slow starter against Colin Lloyd and came back there, but he won't be too keen to give this guy much more of a start, John.
No, but as I say, Walsh was 5-0 up against Dudbridge and trailed 8-7 at one stage. And we remember at Bolton, he was 5-0 up against Tony Ayres from Sussex and actually went on to lose the game, unbelievably. And he was quite distraught afterwards, I can tell you, as anybody would be.
60.
But will that experience harden him now, John, would you think? Or will it prey on his mind?
Exactly. I would suggest the former, Dave.
100.
Crowd packed in to the Winter Gardens, settling down. They know they've got a big night ahead with still to come here this evening. Two men who competed for the world final last year. There is this quite amazing spectacle of the most prestigious darting venue on the planet.
137.
I like it. Well done, lad. I wonder if he did the... Oh, it's very good artistry, I've got to say. We've not just got an artist on the stage. There are a 45. Bundle of them down there in the audience.
Yeah. We will see the power in the shadow of the tower, and it is likely to be another towering performance coming next. Coming out now for 115, really. And look at this.
Well, they've obviously lifted the smoking ban for her, haven't they?
I don't know.
45. Mark, you require 75.
These audiences knock spots off all the rest, don't they?
They do indeed. Play 101, you know, those Dalmatians, that's all.
Double top now for Marsh.
55.
And Painter can't finish on 211, so Walsh knows he'll be back to have a look at double 10.
135.
Not the greatest start again from Painter. Walsh is averaging 105. He's going well at the moment. Now double 5. Mm-hmm.
10 scores.
Well, Painter got that score before, which took him from 211 down to 76. That 135 gives him half a chance. Ought to have at least one darter to double, should he not hit a treble. Now then, 16 for tops, this is what I mean. Now, big dart this, got to get this against the throw.
Game,
oh, yes! Walsh had his moment there, and his chance to go 3-0 up. And Painter manages to hit back against the throw, and now to level up. That was so important, Dave.
Absolutely, it really has put a different complexion on this match. And that's how tight this one is going to be.
We fancy
it is going to be a really close call. Walsh won't be happy. Three darts there. His average came down from 105 to 99 at the back end of that leg. That's how cruel this game is as far as stats. Look again across the Empress Ballroom with its golden ceilings shimmering like the towers of Samarkand.
Yes, we've got a plasterer coming on tonight, haven't we, Steve Brown? I wonder if he was responsible for that. I doubt it somehow. He'd have liked to have been.
Just have a wonderful mental picture of a plasterer trying to do the ceilings here.
Yes.
Do you want Michelangelo?
It's pretty good, isn't it?
Oh, it's terrific. It's just got a style all of its own, just magnificent.
45.
The neo-Gothic cathedral of the darting empire.
Everybody that comes here from all over the world, when we get players and they've come across from the other side of the divide, but they also, when you walk in here and see this venue, it punches the breath back down your throat.
Yeah, of course, all the venues are great. They all have their idiosyncrasies. They all have their own special flavour and atmosphere. And we love them all, but, you know, you're quite right, and we all emphasise it, there's nowt quite like Blackpool. The Empress Ballroom is extra special.
60.
And Walsh again with the chance here.
Yeah, we saw Kevin Painter do it last leg, didn't we?
Double 8 now for 3-1. That's a better finish. That's confident. That's cool.
Well, I used the expression clean as a whistle in the opening leg when he finished in two darts like that, finishing on double 12 on that occasion. But I repeat, lovely to watch and looking so, so at ease with himself, Walshy.
Yes, of course, you'd be feeling much better than that, having been broken, broke straight back with the darts here, still averaging over three figures, 101.32.
85.
Yeah, 15 points difference in the average, and, you know, Walsh might, if later in the game, if there's still 15 points difference, he'll be well on his way to victory.
Well, there are those averages, you can see for yourself, and there is clear daylight between the pair.
Yes, even though it's going dark outside. Clear daylight in here. Well, the sun is setting over the Irish Sea, but plenty of life here in the Winter Gardens. This is the second match of four tonight. The completion of round two. Two quarter-final sessions tomorrow, two games in the afternoon, two in the evening. Really getting out of nitty-gritty time.
Walsh again coming down with a purpose, a constructive purpose, playing workmanlike darts.
80. Mark, you require one.
Painter's having a problem holding on to him. Walsh could check out here for 4-1 at the break. Treble 18 would be useful. And now treble 20 should be the next target.
96.
Yeah, 8 left. And Painter again, a big checkout needed. Walsh outscoring him, as the average suggests, by some way.
60.
Well, he has set it up, but you fancy Walsh won't miss this, Dave, somehow.
Now, that's the target. Now, double 2. And double 1. Time getting a bit short now, but not any longer. And that shows confidence. When a man can move on to double 1 and click it into place, you know he's feeling good with life. And Mark Walsh goes into this break short, feeling that he's done a particularly convincing job in that open session. He leads 4-1. He'll be back to try and consolidate that lead in just a moment.
This magnificent arena here on second round night. Anderson 12, Klassen 14. What a match that was. Many misses, many hits, and all hits here, or most of them going Walsh's way. Painter, as he has before, got work to do. And Beaton and Taylor, well, Taylor's been beaten by Beaton this year. Is it going to happen tonight? Whitlock and Brown to finish us off. Australia versus England, and well, that is tonight, folks. So you know what's to come. You know what's happening here.
Ladies and gentlemen, sixth leg.
And the sixth leg.
To front first. Game on.
Kevin Painter having to hold his throw, Dave. There's no doubt about that.
That's going to do a bit of a recovery job in this session, Painter. Once again,
60.
A little slow, hitting the ground, and Walsh steady, reliable, averaging 97, 36% success rate. And by contrast, curiously, Painter has 100% checkout success rate because he's only had one dart at the double.
Yes, that's a false stat if ever there was, but that isn't. He's only had 180, and you've just seen it. And it may just be the moment where Painter kicks in, because not only has he got a hold his throw, he's got to break back a couple of times as well. Well, once anyway. He's only one break down, by the way. Walsh started this match.
140.
Certainly seemed to find a range of rhythm around treble 20 now, and Painter has got to do a recovery job.
140. Kevin, you require 121.
Wrong treble. But Walsh is a fair way back, and so Kevin Painter knows that he will be back to look at 68.
Yeah, when Painter played Lloyd, Dave, in the first 10 legs, the only thing of note that he seemed to do was an 86 checkout, 18-18 bull. Second leg, didn't do much after that, and trailed 8-2 as we know, but here, double four, he got an impressive finish before on 76, two-dart finish, that's another one. That, for my money, is Painter's best leg of the match.
And he won it comfortably. He'll be feeling better now, never troubled, always looked in control.
55. Not flustered, but that dart just drifting over into the treble five. Oh, lovely last dart. You almost felt that was going to go in, didn't you? He was working down towards it. In reality, he was trying to hit it three times.
100. Yeah, fine switch from Walsh to the big trebles downstairs. Just beginning to click into a bit of form and style.
95.
Now, Painter. It's Walsh with Tantan 40 here. Can stretch his lead down to checkout time. That's not a good dart. Second dart going to come out again. Good friend. That's been a very good friend. There. There's again the happy faces that proliferate here at Blackpool Arena. Is
100.
Such a carnival spirit about our crowds here, and they've been capacity all week.
100.
Just a ton and not satisfied, because Painter can bite back hard here. He set up a lovely shot, didn't he, when he was 211 down to 76 earlier, the one I referred to, and he's done the same again, and we often hear our colleague Rod Harrington talking about that, setting up the shot from the 200s. Painter's done it a couple of times in this game now. That's what he's got to do. Of course, he's still got to finish the job off, but at least he's 94. In a position to do so.
Kevin, you require 68.
68 then for Painter to take another leg back, and this one against the darts. Double 16, taking his time, measuring it up.
36.
Just dropping all. Very, very important miss. And double 10 for Walsh. Oh, big dart, big dart. Oh, 20. Right on the wire. He really is hurting there. 32. He actually nudged it a fraction in. Now then, Dave, is this where the artist bites back against the throw?
He does milk the moment, so doesn't he? Takes his time, swagger. It's a gunfighter swagger about Painter. And that was a picture of Walsh not looking happy with life as that double went in, which means that if Painter wins this leg with throw, we're all square.
Yeah, I can understand where Walsh is coming from. If you miss by a mile, you're annoyed with yourself. If you're on the wire like that, actually move it fractionally, you rather start thinking that lady luck's with the other guy, perhaps. That's impressive from Painter now. 3 out of 4, 1 out of 1. That's more impressive than the 100% he had with 1 out of 1, Dave, because he wasn't getting many shots at a double, was he? But now he's starting to hit the scores, which means he's going to have a go at the doubles.
Well, that's precisely the equation. You can have a very healthy average and not even have a shot at a double.
Yeah, dead right.
100.
Yes, if you can avoid hitting the doubles or going for them, your average might stay up a bit.
That's right.
Thank you, your score won't look very impressive.
Still room in the treble, one fancies.
83.
Room treble.
Well, if he can win this leg and make it 4 apiece, so we really do have a game on again. Not that it wasn't on before, but 4-1 down. He really did have to come back after the session with aplomb, and it looks as though he has done. He was well and truly beached against Colin Lloyd. We all thought that was it at 8-2. Mind you, I've got to say, Kevin said to me afterwards he never doubted at 8-2 that he could get back, but he honestly thought he would lose at 9-5. He really did. Now 112, big checkout, Dave.
Yes, and once again, Painter taking his time, settling down, looking. Double 16 now for 112. Impressive, impressive. And look at the way he responds and his family group, because Painter has really come ripped snorting back out of the break and is all square now after 8 legs.
Yeah, 4-4. And what a session this is for Painter. Average 85.68 at the end of the first session. It's now 91.13. I guess his average for this session so far is round about 97.
44.
And that's good by anybody's standards. Upped the ante. And 4 out of 5 now on the doubles, 80%.
And that is impressive.
60.
And it's just affected Walsh. His average has come down from the high 90s to the low 91.9. Just been knocked off his stride a little, hasn't he?
58.
Looking around for another target. No staying there. Coming up next, well, Beaton versus Phil Taylor. Always an extra charge of electricity when the power is switched on. What new record will Taylor be going for tonight, John?
Well, I don't know. I think he'd just be happy to see Steve Beaton off. And if it happens to be with the help of a record, fine. And now then, Whitlock and Brown. Sounds like high street solicitors, doesn't it, Whitlock and Brown? But anyway, we've got them on the hockey last of all, the Wizard against the lad from
54.
Bristol. And been impressive this week, Simon Whitlock, but Brown, I thought, did very well to beat Terry Jenkins, who admittedly wasn't his normal self. Look at that, Dave. What you can call a green maximum. A green maximum. All due to global warming.
Oh, I could have fooled me in Blackpool.
Yes.
40.
94, that's a treble. Treble 19 shot for Painter has left him a 2-dart potential finish, and this is really a powerhouse finish from Painter for 4 on the turn. Now the marker looks superb.
54.
Oh, he didn't use the dart at all.
At least he's got the chance to come back and polish it off. Been very, very good on double 16. I'm trying to think, I don't think he's had a shot at double top in this game so far until then.
100.
Now then, here we go for 5-4 and the lead for the very first time in the match. Art history. D artistry, call it what you like. Few more of those and Walsh will be history. 5-4 to Painter from 4-1 down.
Yeah, storming session from Kevin Painter.
58.
Well, quite used to seeing healthy leads diminish, evaporate, and he's more or less seen that here from 4-1 up to 5-4 down, and Painter really motoring now. Come back from that first session and really hit hard. Is he going to win all five legs in the session? Could do.
100.
Well, he needs big ton here, Painter, to kick on towards the double finish. And he's going to come out now because the first dart is blocking the treble 20, but he could leave a shot. Hasn't quite needed the treble, but Walsh is still a little bit adrift. Not so now.
Thirty-five
scored, but had that been 95, it'd have been on a bogey number.
Yes, he needed the treble with the third dart, a single, and left him outside the finishing range. Well, all the 19s, well, four of them anyway, then the ball. Can't finish on two now. But chose the five to leave double top, and now Painter should concentrate on 18s, 122. Could be a lovely finish here if he hits the treble.
Yeah, he'd have fancied a treble there out of the two darts, either the first or the second, or both for double seven, but he didn't hit it, and so a chance for Walsh to level up at five apiece, a fraction down again, and it is five apiece. Well measured, a hint of a smile on Walsh's face. Five apiece it is, the darts can have a rest for 2.5 minutes, but we'll be back to see who's going to make the quarterfinals.
Welcome back to Sensational Sharp Shooting by the Sea in Blackpool. A terrific opening match with the Dutchman, Yannick Klassen, just edging out Gary Anderson in a rip-snorting counter. Here, well, it's all square and could hardly be more level and hardly be better poised. Still to come, Phil Taylor, record breaker every time he steps to the hockey against Steve Beaton, who has beaten him in recent times. And finally, the beard to be feared, Simon Whitlock against the young gun. There he is there. Steve Brown from the West Country, that's coming your way under the golden arches of the Winter Gardens here in Blackpool, where Walsh has squared up the match at five apiece. And it has been a level battle, John.
Yes, it has. It's been interesting because both sessions are identical in one regard. First session went to Walsh, 4-1, and Walsh deservedly won that session. He was well ahead of Painter. There's the first session averages. Painter 86, Walsh 97, 11 and a bit between. 4-1 up. Now, the second session, just the five legs of the second session, juxtaposed. Painter 96.2, Walsh 83.6. Complete turnaround. Painter won that session 4-1, and as you would expect, their total average, their average for the two sessions combined, are just about level, and around about the 90-91. There's their three-dart average in the game as a whole, the 10 legs that we played all together. Interesting, that, Dave.
Yeah, well, somebody had a £30,000 bet on Painter, you'll remember, in his opening match against Colin Loy. He had a real nerve-wracking run for his money. I don't imagine anybody will be betting any kind of money with any real confidence on the outcome of this match. It could go either way.
Well, 35. It was treble 18 he was looking for. It was treble 4 that he got, and all the hairstyles. Yeah. Looks like a peacock to me.
That's right.
125.
Edges Painter in front of Walsh. Can't finish on 166. It's one of the bogeys around that particular area. So Kevin Painter 45. Can Kevin take this leg against the throw, which would set him up right at the start of the session to move back into the lead. Double 19. He's going to go for it, I'm sure. Now he's just got an inch edge upwards.
Yeah, with two darts in his hand, he might have thought otherwise had gone somewhere else, but can't blame him, really. Now then, this will hurt. Walsh needing to hold on to his throw, wants the bullseye.
96.
Now, with three darts, Dave, I reckon six double six. He's going to have two darts at double 16. He's going to get it. He's going to get it, isn't he? He's had two darts practice, I suppose. What do I know? Well, 6-5 to Painter. Good game.
It's just a wrinkle of worry showing across the face of Mark Walsh. He had a dart and a double there to take that leg. And Painter duly stepped in when he missed, and Kevin has the darts here, as you can see.
100.
Yes, he did have a dart at a double in the shape of double 25, 50, and it's the toughest double on the board, whatever we say. But he would have liked to have seen it off. 2-1 finish, wouldn't he? And in these sort of tight moments, those are the finishes that really often matter, make the difference.
Well, we saw Phil Taylor famously hit a ball
95.
To win the title here. Remember that 132, which still remains, for my money, the finest shot we've ever seen on television. He had to move about a couple of yards to his right, you'll remember. Taylor always seems to 59. Do something particularly special. Yes, 3D is coming at the weekend as darts moves into a new technical age and era.
85.
Yes. It's going to be fun seeing that, John, isn't it? It's going to be interesting.
Well, certainly is, Dave. Looking forward to it. Got a few darts to be thrown yet, though, before we reach that particular stage.
60.
But certainly a feature that a lot of people are very interested in seeing. First ever on the hockey. And Painter. 140, 81 left. Is he going to put a little bit of daylight now? Looks like it, between himself and Walshy.
Walsh's average has just been 81. Steadily crumbling.
Well, after five legs, he averaged 97.21. I know after four legs, he was averaging 101. But wasn't able to maintain that. Had he done so, he'd have gone on to win the game, I'm sure. Not necessarily yet, but he'd have been well on the way. Well, but fair credit to Painter. He's hit back, and I think that's affected Walsh.
While Walsh has been stumbling, Painter has been rumbling. And still does, rumbles further. 7-5. That's the first time he has held a two-leg advantage in the overall scores. And that's why, with that double.
Yeah, 5-6 legs now to the last seven have gone to Painter. So really on a roll. But because of the indifference start he made, hardly won it yet. I think she's got 3D on her mind already.
Lost.
Three-dimensional darts. Who would have thought that when we started our coverage? We didn't even have slow motion. I think we had colour when I first started, John.
100.
Yes, that's right. Wireless darts, Dave, for you, wasn't it?
Painter's looking good.
140!
I recall you and Sid once doing a radio commentary on darts. I've done one myself, but
yeah.
A few years ago.
It was like a radio juggling act.
100!
But the lads are here, and happy faces, and the relaxed holidaymaking. There's a great, great feel about Blackpool and the big time darts.
58!
Wasn't what Painter was looking for. He'd like to stretch ahead, he'd like to put more distance between him and his opponent because Walsh is steady and still dangerous.
Oh yes, he's certainly, his body language suggests that he's very, very much still in the match. He believes he is, and Painter, well, he's doing his best to dispel that. What a game! What a wonderful 180 that was! Again, talking about setting the shot up from 208 to double. 28, double for Walsh to deny. Setting it up beautifully, Dave, double 14, he nearly didn't get a shot at it. Walshy disappointed at missing that.
For a double break, and that 180 has set him up and turned this leg around, and that's the target, and now he's got to come down for double 7. He's just hit 19s next door, and he's hit that one. He's very happy in that little corner, cow corner of the board. But he's yielding results like that for Kevin Painter.
Well, you know, in this game now, 8-5 to Painter, and he's throwing first. Walsh held his throw in the opening leg of the match, the fifth leg, and he hasn't held it in any of the other legs. He's lost the third on his throw, the seventh on his throw, the ninth, the 11th, and now the 13th. That is critical for him. He's got to hold his throw.
And just remembering that after 10 legs here in Blackpool, it looks like Kevin Painter is going to be going home on a Blackpool donkey. But here he is now, looking good for his best ever world match play. He's never been beyond this round. Five times he's faltered at the second round, but now, if he can just hold his nervous equilibrium and prevent Walsh just getting the win behind him.
140!
Kevin Painter will be looking at his best ever Blackpool to date, and still more to come.
There's more aggression in his throw, physically, I believe, more aggression in his throw than earlier in the game, or any time in the game, Colin Lloyd.
Yes, he attacks the board. Painter, other players like Phil Taylor, Barneveld, caress the board.
Yeah. I did do the Lloyd game and was saying that he's almost inanimate, Painter. There doesn't seem to be any real spark about him. He kept it within, in fairness to him. But now you begin to see, seeing here the real Kevin Painter, living every dart, letting us know what he's thinking about each one.
Treble 17 here would be useful for the bullseye for 161, the finish. Oh, long way away, long way away.
Yeah, finds it hard to understand why he was so far away. 95. Maybe that's an indication of nerves creeping into the arm, denying him the weight on the arrow.
Which way would he go? He could probably go for the ball, though he has hit double 19. Yeah, treble 18. Could have gone anywhere there, but he's still got a good shot. And then a double top, because that is in there. Once again, weighs up the moment. Takes his time, looks at the double.
55.
Well, she didn't hit the ball by a long shot, but he can here hit double 8 and just ease the pain a little. Yes, it's against the throw. That's what he's got to do. A couple more times yet, but at least he's on his way back.
It's a very tight, tight match. We thought it would be evenly matched, this pair. Walsh hammering the treble. 180. He is loving the lipstick.
Yeah, to the tune of two 180s, same as Painter. Identical average, 92.01, 92.69, almost identical anyway. And in the other stats, well, Walsh had a higher score on the tons, Painter marginally on the one on the 140s.
A lot of room in the bed, isn't there? Still, you could drive a tram through there. You could get another six starts in that second of the board. Wonderful shooting. Watch it again and applaud.
Yep, got it despite the ricochet.
100.
Well, that's a good-looking turn, a hard-looking turn. Probably deserved more. Interesting leg this, because Painter, with a decent score, can set it up again. Well, it's from that sort of position where he's been getting the big scores. Not on that occasion, though. So still Walsh with the slight, more than a slight advantage now. Oh, this time he'll make a better shot of the ball. Oh, but he didn't, Dave. He didn't. He compensated too much.
Yes, overcompensation again. That's twice. He's bitterly disappointed that he's just missed two of the party piece finishes in big time darts. But still, he should be back to bring this 65. Match back to within one leg of his grasp. 49, which way is he going to go? 15, we'll leave him 16, double 8 here.
Game set in the 15.
Well, Nathan Tardy comes to mind as in the early part of the game, and a sign of Walsh hitting back. This game still has loads of life in it yet. Who's gonna win? A smile on Walsh's face. Yes, he's happier now. Painter though leads by 8 legs to 7.
Just joined us in bracing Blackpool. You've missed a cracker of an opening match with the Dutch kid Jelle Klassen just edging out the Flying Scotsman Gary Anderson 14-12. But you're still in time to see the climax of a very close match between Kevin Painter and Mark Walsh here. Just the one leg between the pair. Still to come, the giant of giants in darting terms, Phil Taylor against Steve Beaton. And then the man they call the Thunder from Down Under, Simon Whitlock, against the new kid on the block, Steve Brown. A colourful, character-packed evening, and even the statues on the wall are paying attention as darts start flying once again for the 17th year in Blackpool. Jess got to hold his throw in this particular session, one feels with Painter. Painter, who was trailing 3-1, 4-1 indeed after 5 legs, got it back to 7-5, 8-5 after 13. And Walsh has come back. It's been one of those kind of matches. It's been difficult to call, tight, swinging one way and the other. Maybe not a high scoring whiz bang classic. But it's the kind of game that's got some nitty-gritty and some real red meat, John.
Yeah, that's right. And an honest darts match. And two lads who've not made the quarterfinals before. In fact, Painter hadn't made the second, I think I'm right in saying. And Walsh never gone beyond it. But ambitious they both are.
Yes, and you have to say, John, a reminder that both of these players have made a televised final.
Oh, yes.
Both times they were beaten by, who else, Phil Taylor?
Yes,
Painter's family, his lady Janine, I saw in the background there. And she'll be happy with that. That again, a crisp finish. Dance equivalent of keyhole surgery from Kevin Painter.
Well, he's pretty handy at keyhole surgery too at times. And now, 3 1/8s apiece. Really warming 60. Up into it.
Cracking match. Walsh here with another 180 would set our pulses racing. Painter knows, having started rather disappointingly, he's got to hold on here, he's got to consolidate, he can't afford any lapses. That two-leg gap, he's got to win, of course, by two legs in the final analysis. He just can't afford any banana skins.
134.
Yes, he's one break ahead on Walsh, so he has... just to hang 54. On to this position if he can. Easier said than done, as Walsh looks likely to move within one leg of him again. He doesn't have to go 20 bull. More conventional route, if you like, and knows he'll be back as Painter. Oh, he's well and truly way back.
Yes, fair leg against the throw here from Mark Walsh. He's right down at a double, way ahead 45. Of his rival. Double top here to make it 9-8. Then he would have the darts. Should be a useful marker. I've got to use the darts. Yes, does so. Just got the merest whisper of a kiss there.
18th leg, he's coming to throw first.
That's a 14 darter, Dave, and Walsh, I'm not saying that at any stage he looked ragged. He didn't. He's held himself together. Even when Painter had that run, he held himself together. His main fault was that he just wasn't scoring as well as he had been earlier in the game. Now, we'll be seeing some scoring from that man, I'm sure, because he's the next one up against Steve Beaton. And you can look forward to a few big scores 24. There, all right. Now, Walshy there, clearly not happy with his throw. But that's the practice room. See Steve Brown in the background as well, waiting for his game on last.
46.
Taylor looking extremely relaxed. He always does in the practice room, doesn't he?
I can't when he's on stage as well.
Oh, I don't know. I think he gets the flutterbys a little bit. Certainly was given one or two little reminders that... there are other players in the tournament by Barry Bates the other night.
Yes, Barry Bates performed heroically against him, gave him a little bit of a fright.
Oh, lovely darts here again. Now they're popping in again. It's funny how a player can go through a game where he has a period where he's not throwing badly, but just not hitting the red bit, just not, and he missed doubles, of course, and then suddenly he rediscovers it. Now, in Kevin Painter's case, he started poorly, indifferently, and picked it up beautifully. Now it looks as though Walsh is doing the same. Got over that bad patch. But Painter favourite to take the leg.
90 the shot. 18s or 20s for Painter. Treble 15 would leave 40. You know the double. He knows it. Licks his fingers. Goes through this routine. Settles down. Focuses. Releases, hits the target. That was classic Kevin Painter, through his routine, and it worked perfectly for him.
Yes, it did, Dave. It was a poor first dart. You can't pretend otherwise, but what a great recovery. And again, two darts. I know it was a three-dart finish, but it was the last two that so reminiscent of darts we'd seen earlier in the match from him. Setting it up. On that occasion, not setting it up with the five, but finishing it off beautifully. And now, following that on with another fabulous start. Well, and there's the other man who's going to be playing, Phil Taylor. He's never other than super cool, that man, Dave.
And he has beaten Taylor in comparatively recent times. But Kevin Painter with a rare opportunity to kick on here. Needs the treble.
60.
Walshy Jr. supporting Dad. Got the same haircut. So 77 only. And what a chance for Walsh here. For Painter here, rather. Got to get a couple of trebles to hammer home the advantage. That's a good dart. That's a good dart. Could make a major difference. Ton ahead. Now Walsh, he needs a 140. Minimum.
Painter's left himself a big finish, but that was very effective cover shooting from the artist. And now 167, and this would give Blackpool a rare shot in the arm if he could hit this one. It's a grand old crowd pleaser. It's on. Don't think he's going to go for it, though. He knew, he had a quick look, and Painter quite reasonably working the odds, working the percentages, knew that Walsh couldn't finish.
Yeah, sensible. 186, Walsh. And
mind you, the way he went getting a 5 when he won an 87 wasn't exactly in the game plan, was it?
That's right. That was 90, wasn't it, he was going for, and he got the treble 15 double top to follow up the 5. He wants the 25, or better still, the 50 here. More likely to get the 25 than the 50 for some reason. But you never know. There you are. 17 for tops. Now then, got it last leg. Having hit the treble 15, can he get it now, having hit the single 17 for 11-8 and a 3-leg lead? No, he's annoyed with himself, and Walsh has got to get 46, Mr. Lanning.
To reduce the deficit again, double 18.
Game turn and 19.
Well, admiration for Walsh there, he picked that off beautifully. And Damson's in September comes to mind. That was beautiful, under pressure. This game still has length and life in it. But Painter knows that if he can hold his throw, and he's well on his way already in this leg, he can inch ever closer.
Yes, a guarantee of £15,000 and the opportunity of a quarter-final meeting potentially with Phil Taylor, maybe with Steve Beaton. And that will be further than ever before for Kevin Painter, though of course he has made a final of the World Championship when famously and historically he really gave Phil Taylor the shakes and should have won it. Painter still with the darts. Just love the way this guy approaches. His routine. He licks his fingers, and this could be finger licking good.
Oh yes. Well, whether you're in Kentucky or on the field, it can be nerve-wracking stuff for those who are closest to the player. Actually, far more nervous for the spectators. Close friends, that's Janine, his girlfriend, of course. Sweating and fretting.
100.
Well,
yes,
I to Kevin to make sure.
I well remember when Kevin was beaten here 1 year, and Janine said, I think he's going to kill himself. He was so distraught. He said it with a beautiful straight face. Anyway, we want to kill this now. 76 to go, 11-9. He's just two legs away from a place in the quarterfinal. 76 to shot, two clean throws. He's licked the fingers. He's focused the darts. He looks at the target. He has hit the target. That is a gunfighter's skill and talent. From Kevin Painter, who goes 11-9 up, and the checkered flag is now tantalisingly within touch for Painter.
Well, the second game on here, but the first one that preceded it saw Klassen go through, the Dutchman, one in the quarterfinals. Could be another one or two yet to follow. As the second game, as I say, is on. How much longer have we got? 11-9, Painter two away from victory. But can Walsh bite back? Then beaten Taylor. Yep, that's going to be good fun. Quality stuff again. Game four, Whitlock the Wizard against Brown. The 29-year-old enjoying Blackpool like the rest of us here in the Empress Ballroom. And there you have it, the scene set. The final throws, spell it how you like. 11-9 to Painter. You fancy Walsh can get back here? They've
big
got to
leg,
hold his throw.
Big leg here, big leg here. He's got to hold his throw here. If Painter can overturn him here, then that could be the moment the match is won and lost. So this is a vitally important leg for both players.
91.
And I know Walsh, being a good old pro, will know just how important it is that he turns in a solid performance in this leg.
140.
And he really is a good pro. You're dead right there, Dave, because he's a man who's had his problems. We've highlighted them on occasions with his dartitis. He's come back from that. That's part of his past now, I'm happy to say. Four Pro Tour titles in 2009, another two this year. That's tournaments away from the telly, and in some respects they're harder to win. Far more players enter.
97.
And you've got to win seven or eight games over the course of a day. And Walsh has won a couple of those. He's done well again this year. It really is a true darting pro.
162,246 in earnings on the circuits, but now Walsh on 164, treble 18, and Painter's on the finish as well, so I feel he would have had to go for it had he hit the treble 18, and now Painter, and this really would be a showstopper. If he could hit this now, it would surely be a match-winning contribution. 170, not on. Ball would leave in the tops.
94.
Well, that leaves 76, and he's had that a couple of times in two different ways during this match. 53 left. He'll go 13 for tops.
Big dart.
Wayward first dart, but whoa. Yes, it is.
Game shine, the 21st.
Big dart. How big?
22nd. 11-10. Game on.
Rather than 12-9, that's how big.
Now the pressure's on Painter, because he knows if he should lose this leg, then Walsh can come with a beautifully timed run right at the end. Fascinatingly poised this match, fascinatingly poised.
But still that one vital throw, that one vital break in Painter's favour. And as I said a few legs ago, if he holds his throw, he knows that he cannot be caught. And interestingly, every leg has gone with throw. This is the 22nd since the break of throw in the 14th. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 on the trot now. That's okay from Painter's point of view, but not from that of Walsh.
And another interesting point we have sort of overlooked, John, is that Painter is checking out at nearly 60%,
94.
Which is pretty good at any level. And 11 out of 19, which is an indication if he gets near the double, he's been deadly, and he needs to hit 60. Two more.
Yeah, they're 32%, 11 out of 34 against Lloyd. Similar, Walsh 12 out of 34, 35% against Dudbridge, but yeah, that's impressive. Walsh about the same, 36%, 10 out of 28.
100.
And you see, he's only had that one big finish, 112.
That's right, 112, yes. Well, I think I have mentioned this several times, he set up the two-dart finish and polished it off a few times.
96.
So, done 40. That's not a bad start. May even get more. May even get more. Oh, would have loved that treble 18. Would have loved that treble 18. But he's given himself a real chance of breaking, Dave.
Absolutely. And you have to admire Mark Walsh. He's held on to Kevin Painter's trousers here, metaphorically, like a hound dog, with his teeth in the seat of his pants. He hasn't given in.
That first dart left 109. It was impossible for him to go out in two darts then. So Walsh knows he'll be back here to level up at 11 apiece. And
84.
This is the kind of two-dart finish we've seen Painter take out 68 earlier on.
That was a cracking dart in the ball, you know. Might have been too late, the effort, as Walsh looks at double four again. This is a vitally important throw.
60.
Well, that says all. The importance of that miss 40. Illustrated in Walsh's reaction.
And now Painter going through his time-honoured routine, taking his time, looking down, licking the finger, focusing in, licking again. This gunfighter's routine, looking at double top, and hitting it. And once again, that's over 60%, exactly 60% checkout success rate. And Walsh knows that could be the crippler. Two darts and a double to take the leg. And Painter moved in, and you can see what that dart meant to him.
Yeah, there have been a number of occasions in this match where Walsh has had his opportunity. We've seen him disappoint two or three times now. Painter step in. I don't want to overemphasize that, because Painter deserves, in my opinion, to be where he is on his own merit, on his own darts. He has thrown quite magnificently, barring the first five legs of the match.
But again, you have to acknowledge this fella. He has refused to be intimidated. He's not been overawed. He's not allowed Painter a moment of relaxation, of comfort. Coming out of here now, 177.
Well, he's had a 171, that's a maximum on the 19s. We remember that, that was back in the ninth leg of the match. And that 177 followed by a 180. Oh, he's not going to give up, Walsh. He's got to win this leg, of course, with throw and then break back straight away. What a great effort from Walsh. 81 after just 9 darts, but he's got to repeat this next leg, Dave.
Got time here, though. Got a breathing space, double 12. Painter's way back. A polished leg from Walsh.
Well, that was identical to an 81 he took out earlier in the match. And I said, yeah, sweet as a nut or something of that nature. And that certainly was. So we're still in that situation where Painter, hold his throw, wins the match. Big leg, and I cannot overemphasize that. We've had several big moments, big darts in this match. This, the biggest leg. Whoever wins, I think, possibly goes on to win the match. Painter certainly does, of course.
And Painter 100. Starts with the ton. They both match each other with the opening scores. Again, Painter with this routine. Gosh. Never mind artist, he's like an actor when he moves in. Coming out very quickly. That's a long way away from the cover shot as well.
48!
And that has left the door ajar for Mark Walsh. Got to take advantage, he's coming down quickly. Tension beginning to build.
58!
Yes, it's hard to explain sometimes. Even the greatest pros, sometimes the arm just won't quite do it the same. Nerves, very difficult thing to control. And both players are mastering, trying to master that as well as throw their darts where they want them to. believe you me, they'll both be feeling nervous right now. Yeah, Tainter on the verge of victory and a place in the quarters.
And the first signs of real pressure showing from Kevin Painter, and Walsh is aware of it. And Walsh is taking advantage of this match, is still bubbling and bursting with energy.
Yeah, that was Walsh at his very, very best. Now then, this is Painter. At his most aggressive, but only a ton advantage, Walsh.
And Walsh has stolen the darts here at a very, very important moment.
100.
A ton in this situation worth quite a bit more, I think, psychologically anyway. Now then, a ton 40 here will really make this leg interesting. Oh, will it just? 87 left, Kevin. Coming down for treble, 17. 17, when he goes, if he goes, Walsh 103.
103 then. Treble 17 must be the next target. Treble 10 would leave him a double. The ball might come into the equation, but now Kevin Painter on 70 for the match, John. Which way will he go? He will take his time, that's for sure.
Yes, you can bet your life. He'll take a deep breath. He'll lick his fingers. He'll say, come on. He'll walk onto the red bit, up to the hockey, and he'll go treble 18. Half the job done. Double 8 for a famous 13-11 victory, double 4. Oh, 66. Two match points gone. Mark, Walsh kisses his darts. Chance for him now for 12 apiece.
Stark despair in the Painter camp. And Walsh is an unemotional cove. He'll step in. You always feel the inevitability of this as the marker is in place. Oh, interesting. Oh, that's surely. And that is, again, absolute desperation in the family camp as Painter now steps in with another chance he could not have been anticipating, John.
Yeah, amazing, wasn't it? He hit the treble 18 last leg so beautifully, but couldn't hit the double, which is bigger. Now then, Walsh had his moments there, had his chance, so here for a 13-11 victory and a first ever quarter-final place here at Blackpool. He's got to somehow get that over the top. You can see the camera's got it beautifully, but Painter hasn't, and the nerves are really now gentle, not just in Kevin Painter's
eye. Well, this is more than sport. This really is pure theatre.
Well, it is, and whatever Walsh said to Painter, he certainly had put his darts away. Can't believe it. Now, for Painter, of course, losing this leg doesn't mean he's lost the match, but he's bound to be thinking, well, I've had 5 match points. Walsh to save the match. Double 5.
There it is. Again, it's the marker. He's got to come down half an inch. The drama still piling on. And now then, look at Painter. These are absolutely magical moments. Painter has had, what, 5 darts here now. And now looking at double 2. Again, this routine. And you just wondered, John, maybe if he broke his routine, stepped up and hit it, it'd all be over. Let's watch. Let's see. Let's enjoy it. Again, it's on the wire, still room there, still room down the bed. Oh!
8 match points. Well, his doubling has been absolutely brilliant. He had 12 out of 20, 60%, and then when it comes to the moment, 8 misses on the trot, but Walsh saved the day. Painter gave him a heck of a lot of milk. 12 apiece, got a win by 2 clear legs. Well, I suggested, Dave, that whoever wins that leg goes on to win the match, possibly. Painter, of course, certainly would have done. Is the advantage now surely with Walsh.
And isn't it wonderful, these pictures, how the despair can turn to delirium just on the strength of one dart. And psychologically, you've got to reckon this man now, because he's got out of jail and further, more deeply in jail than Clint Eastwood was at Alcatraz.
Yeah, precisely my point. The winner of that leg, if you like, was in the ascendant. Painter would have been off the stage celebrating as the winner.
Oh, those are ragged darts. But those are really ragged darts from Painter.
And the indication there, 140 from Walsh, and ragged darts, can't put them any other way from Painter, rather again emphasises the point we've been making.
26.
At least he had a 140 before it.
You really can't script this business, can you? It's
well, I've torn my script up long ago. So he's got the 140. Unbelievable. Well, Taylor and Beaton practicing. Might have thought they'd be on in a minute or two. Any time. And of course, if Painter hit the double, they'd have been, well, getting ready now to make their walk on. But they're going to have to wait a bit longer. I hope this isn't a 70-68 affair like they had at Wimbledon first day. Got to be won by two clear legs, though, and, well, until it is, we carry on.
Well, the drama has been a considerable nature, and the youngsters enjoying the fun as much as this audience, because as you say, we may have seen more exhilarating scoring and finishing and dart play, but you can hardly match this for drama.
You're right, and the beauty about this is the main players, there's such a contrast between them. He's in a sense just mocking this game. He looks very cool, and now and again he gets a little bit angry with himself. Occasionally you see a smile. But what a contrast to Painter.
98.
Who's now got 98 to leave 40. So Walsh, who started with the 140, disappointingly trailing from his point of view. This against the throw for Painter, Dave. What an opportunity.
Again. He's hurrying his routine. Yes, he is. He's got up to the hockey a lot quicker here. It's quite remarkable. He was at 60%. We spoke about it and said how cleverly he built that up and unobtrusively. Now it's down below 40%.
He's now missed 11 darts at a double, 8 of them for the match. But he's got another chance. Now Walsh, they're both missing doubles, of course. And the effect of intense nervousness, I've absolutely no doubt about that. It doesn't matter whether you're playing up there on the one of the greatest stages you could play on. Sometimes down at the club, when nerves get a hold, all sorts of things happen, but Painter got it. He's got that against the throw.
Where's the dart? It propels him into the lead again. Opportunity once again. It was at 6 match points he allowed to drift away. 8, in fact, just checking back.
Yes, it was.
And just got to kick on, got to kick on.
85.
Two, he had two darts at a double first visit. He wanted 70, didn't he? Got the treble 18. Missed the two darts, then three more, and then three more.
100.
He's got that leg. 25 played, but got to win by two clear legs.
Janine can't watch.
No. Only 55. She can hear the scores, though. Well, so for at least that. Interestingly, 9 legs on the trot with throw. Suddenly two go against the throw, and we're here in this situation. Looks as though this one might.
Superb last two darts from Walsh on the 19s. That's a very good first start. Still room in the treble, one suspects.
140!
Puts him on 1-6-7, a lead of 54, already eliminated.
100.
This is a nip on top leg.
167 again. We mentioned this is a crowd's favourite. Treble 19. The ball for 1-6-7. The kill.
Oh, and again he's miles away from the ball. That's more like one of Willie Walsh's flights than one of Mark Walsh's flights. And 32 sitting on but a treble 17. And Bullseye will win the match for Kevin Paxton! Can't believe it! I wonder if Walsh can, Dave.
Well, again, it's unbelievable. It's not too close either. Neither's that. Now double eight next door.
Oh. 16.
And it was right between those two darts, rather like the Dampbusters going in between those two, and it just went to the left of the wire. Frustration
personified. Surely Painter now has two more darts to consolidate and make the quarterfinals again. Should use the marker. Does use the marker. Kevin Painter is on his knees, but tomorrow morning he'll be in the quarterfinal and he'll be on top of the world.
Drama theater on the Empress Ballroom stage. Smiles across the faces of Kevin Painter's supporters. Wonderful match, and Painter wins by 14 legs to 12.
And coming next, it's Phil Taylor.
What we're dealing with here is a total lack of respect for the law.
The adrenaline is pumping.
Dealing with here is a total lack of respect for the law.